icing on top of the cake that's already delicious, or it's not going to be relevant. So Nogari's going to be hunting the Aatrox on the top side.
And also her most recent buff is actually relevant here as well, with the fact that Concussive Blows is now completely blocked by the Riposte
instead of
just stalled.
And we get the Camille mid as well. We didn't even talk about it. We papered over it, but Camille mid, a big pick in Korean solo queue recently into a lot of different matchups, specifically melee.
Has gone for the more aggressive choice in picking up the Sheen on first back. We actually saw a very curious first back Tia coming out from Jhin Air in their first game. They then lost, and Rule has gone with the more winning option here in the Sheen pickup. Speaking of pickups, Damwon should be freely able to get this Infernal Drake. Peanut was happening at 15 and a half minutes in your games of League of Legends, everyone at home, is Cube. Speaking of which, going to be having a bit of a rough time. Not going to find too much value with the old Riposte, but that's because that doesn't matter.
Let me introduce new Aatrox in lane.
Yeah.
You just kill him.
Slow down, but the cleanse is going to be there. Beryl creating some distance, and Nuclear just keeping him alive for so, so long. Nogari, he smells blood. Canyon is here as well. Peanut, a good kick is going to come in there as Nogari is slowed down, and the Arctic Assault is not going to land onto life. He is going to be the first one to go down, and Damwon at five underneath the turret. That is going to be that. Nogari gets out of turret range. They take down another one. And Gen.G are watching everything fall apart.
Gen.G just didn't know how bad it was because they lack a teleport on Cube. He teleported back to topside to not lose the turret, and guess
Ravage
what?
Hydra, of course, is what we're thinking.
All right, we're sending everyone top.
Is three going to be enough? World Ender already popped as Nogari moves, and Cube decides he wants to get the heck out of there. Grand Challenge is down, and he flashes after Cube. Not going to be able to get too much more. There's the Riposte for the last hit, but he can't get onto the healing, and Peanut's going to kick him even further away.
No, pushing up alone, that's the way he plays. They're engaging the four,
yeah,
though.
They're going to dive on forward. The Hextech Ultimate comes down into the back line, and Ruler is still alive, landing so much damage here. First, it's going to be Showmaker falling. Riposte comes in, but Ruler, he's out of that pit. Peanut as well isn't in there any longer as Kuzan is going to go Golden True Shot Barrage. Lands onto Beryl and Gen.G, can they actually do it? Cube grabs one, is going to get taken down in the end, and now Nogari may have bitten off more than he can chew. He has! It's the Frozen Thralls, they're doing so much damage! And Nuclear, can you get out of the way? I don't think so, as Rule is just waiting for an arc.
That crescendo.
Canyon just waiting for his ways in. There are so many wards. Showmaker going to get the first stun here as life. He's going to get healed up. Kuzan as well diving into this fight. Canyon getting kicked out, but Nogari's at full health. You have to pay attention to that because it's so scary. Great safeguard to get Peanut out of the way, and it is going to be Cube, the sacrificial lamb. Yep, absolutely. And Nuclear, he's just happy to wander around the mouth of this pit, making sure that everyone is absolutely okay. The heals for days, and even the extra can keep pushing here if they can get any picks. Kuzan diving into the back line. He's the one that's looking to try and get work done. He goes golden. He tries to proto belt out, but he's just dead. Damwon playing it slowly but surely. And they grab the Lee Sin like he was an afterthought. It's all too easy. Triple kill so far for Showmaker. Make it a quadra kill. Can he get the penta roar? And a penta kill in day one of LCK Summer. Welcome, Damwon Gaming.
Live it up to his name. Advantages from the Cannon Barrage.
Yeah, he's going to say sorry for, you know, the fact that an Aatrox is going to be 40 CS ahead of him. However, Ruler's going to be having a much better time. And if that's the case, then you certainly understand exactly why Gen.G are thinking about this. I'm just a little bit sad that their playstyle has not evolved at all. Ever.
A lot of old docks, you know?
Yeah,
that's
honestly.
World
a lot more wards back in those days, Atlas. All those wards are gone, and so has Gen.G's favorite. Canyon has to get out, actually. His life could have got a solo kill.
He could have. Beryl's going to make his way up, though, and this means that Peanut's actually looking to try and control this dragon.
Huh, we really want to get in on this one.
Yeah, Peanut should be able to get this smite down, as you can see. Oh, so many skill shots landing there as Peanut's trying to create distance. Not able to get himself over as Ruler is basically out of this fight. The dragon is going to reset for the moment, but Abscond is going to work out here for Kuzan. Life is going to stand on the Crystal Spire as well, so Peanut's going to be able to pull out this dragon. And it will be Gen.G grabbing the first objective on the map and evening out the goal. Hurting Cube more and more, especially after the buffs, because that barrel is at least going to land. Canyon's just looking for a way to utilize his Hail of Blades and now finds his way in. Cube, not exactly a huge health by the flash forward. And that is going to be the reset this time around. Canyon's not going to
wander on over and find Canyon here. He's actually thinking of diving in onto Kuzan.
He's going to get snared up. That's a great knock up there as Dench United comes down onto Canyon as well. Life diving on forward, cannon barrage there, so Gen.G playing the defensive game well. They're going to get one kill. Kuzan now looking for more. Showmaker, his relatively squishy Noggery.
Tremor Sense and maybe finishing off one member and inevitably dying. So it's not going to be huge.
Speaking of Tremor Sense, that is Kuzan getting stunned up. The Mimic Chain is not going to land. Still, Kuzan is going to die. The Flash comes out of Showmaker because he was scared.
Ult for QSS earlier. Someone still leashing this Drake. What are we going to see here? Noggery.
Yep. Three have been tagged there by Ruler's Ultimate. It is going to be the Rek'Sai taking down the Dragon, but they do lose the Shen for it. The Impale comes down, and Noggery has to try and take someone down if he wants to keep himself alive at the World Ender, but he was looking for
this turret as he gets dove on once again. Nuclear in trouble here as Life and Ruler are looking for it. They do find Beryl.
Ultimate's going to come down. On the Hunt is there, but Peanut should be able to get it. Good stun comes in. Doesn't even need the Zipper. Does have those options. Cubase dead underneath this turret, most likely. The teleport is going to come in. Noggery's still looking for it. The Flash is going to come forward. Now he's able to get that revive, and the Bloodwell is going to be utilized. 30% of the health bar actually looks absolutely gigantic here as Kuzan does have the World Ender of his own. Can they do it? They do manage to get one, and Kuzan
hanging around towards this Baron Pit area.
And Cannon Barrage is going to come in. They're starting yet another fight, and it feels like Gen.G have found some Ergs, Papa Smitty. They have found some proactive plays around this map. They keep this minion wave alive. Peanut tanked that one up.
Dream from Gen.G is to blow Noggery's teleport and then try to play the map. Here's a Zipper ult.
Yep, the Hunt comes in. Peanut actually flashing forward for that Impale. Cannon Barrage comes down. Good knock up onto Kuzan, who gets into the back line. It's the Aatrox that's already dead, though, as Beryl is going to follow suit. Cuve turning up late, but better late than never, buddy. They are going to be able to win this fight. It's the Shen that goes down.
Huge Mimic Distortion into the back line as well as Nuclear.
Doing so much damage. That's the Void Rush coming out. Ruler is going to be taken down, traded for the jungler, but the Baron is stopped by Darmwar.
6.5, something like that. It's another Cannon Barrage. Gets the Flash out of Nuclear. On the Hunt is now available for Kuzan.
The chase is most certainly on. Abscond. He's going to come forward. There's a True Shot Barrage as Ruler gets it done. Now Canyon taken down for the double kill, and Gen.G say, yep, you reckon you could stop this one?
Base. Stand United shield is really huge. It's in goes Showmaker diving over the wall. He lands some chains. It's a Cannon Barrage.
Once again in a great position. Noggery now 1v4. It's not what you want. The Sterix is going to keep him alive as he flashes over the wall. But now Showmaker is out of position. Kuzan dives forward and Cubated shoots him in the head.
World Ender
for Noggery, there are a lot of cooldowns that just aren't available. Beryl gets a bit of his health bar back, but that's just going to be taken down so quickly, and Canyon is dead as an afterthought. Kuzan finishes that off, and now the Nexus is going to go. They might get a few kills just for the fun of it as Beryl's going to fall. Cuve grabs yet another one. Noggery on the fountain is not where this man wants to be.
In the bottom center of the screen is actually for SK Telecom's streaming service that does a Pro View like scenario on mobile. So on mobile, you can actually see the POV streams of up to 10 players at once, which sounds really small on a mobile.
Coming back very, very quickly. Canyon takes that one down, but that's a great snare. The Lissandra putting in some fantastic work from Kuzan's side. But Canyon, he's able to get the flash out. Waits on the flash as well, does Kuzan. And that is going to be Canyon being taken down. But it is the jungle is traded, and now Kuzan is in trouble. Ring of Frost, great position to get to, but I have a feeling he's not out of the woods yet. And that is going to be the... Well, Noggery isn't. He's 100% close to dead. As our Peanut locks that one down, and the crowd goes
succeeded in doing it anything but facetiously. That's what happens when these things happen. As our light binding into all of the big buttons.
Copy the spell.
No, that's a toughie. Kuzan not going to be able to seal it with the Q and the Mountain Drake, the second one here of the game, going over to Darmon. In fact, they have a monopoly.
Even though you'd think she'd be piloting. You know, Ash's dead.
Yeah, Beryl's dead. See, mate. Sorry about that.
Not on the beach, but there was certainly sipping mojitos by the pool.
We're sipping Baron real fast.
Yeah. This Purple Worm is going down very, very quickly, but Darmon are going to move away from it as Cuve teleports in. Managing to bait that one out as Kuzan moves on for the flank as well as... Darmon are looking to try and get some sort of wraparound, looking for the positional advantage, don't find it, and back away. And in fact, now Gen.G are able to take down the entire outer ring of turrets.
Their main damage dealer has all of their escape tools no longer available as Beryl. This is what happens when you don't hit that aftershock. Does eventually find it, but doesn't actually get any value whatsoever.
Who smites? Remember, Noggery's already switched over.
Yeah, he's got that one. Life is now over the wall. Peanut wants to find his opportunity moment to get in. He gets in there. The 50-50 is won by Darmwon. It's now Kuzan into the backside. Kyubey has his ultimate, but that's not where the damage is.
Hits the dumb one game.
Kyubey, ultimate is going to miss there onto Noggery. He does have the pull as the Hemo Plague is already down, but is he just going to die? No, he's not. The autos are there, and Kyubey keeps himself alive.
Spawned,
and Dumb on a straight back on it. There is no smite on Noggery this time around. Canyon has his, but Kyubey is looking to just take things down. It's a 50-50 once again, and it's stolen by Zaya. What the heck? Gen G, they have the Baron, and they might just win the fight here as well, as Beryl is in trouble, but never mind. Noggery's trying to turn this one around. Ruler still alive, doesn't get any snares though, and now Showmaker is chasing after him. That knock-up, not going to find the target. Can he get the next one? The answer's no. Double knock-up.
Ruler,
can he do it? 2 versus 3. Noggery goes into the Sanguine Pool, and they are running away from the bottom lane of Gen G. Meanwhile, Kyubey is just going to try and take down this Nexus. Nuclear is dead, and Kyubey says, guys, is it okay if I win? Is that all right? He's going to flash over, and Noggery's going to end that party. But still, Gen G are trying to fight. It is going to be the final spark landing, but it doesn't do a lot of damage. Ruler turns around, kills him. The pesky support doing some silly things, and now you know who the real carry is.
Fight against a Super Creep, as the explosive cast does about nothing. Hemo Plague goes down, but is that going to be the best? Sanguine Pool comes out just in time for Noggery,
but it's Ruler. He's able to get so much work done. Oh my god, this Zaya, triple kills there. Beryl's gonna go down. It's the Quadra, and it's the game. Gen G on the board, picking up their first game.